Hi friends, hope everyone's doing well. This side, Tanvi with you today. And today we will learn about the AC ohmic losses and how to determine the loss in Pvsyst. In this session, we will discuss about AC cable losses and transformer losses in detail. We will also show you how to design your PV system with these losses in Pvsyst. We have covered all the loss components of Pvsyst in this series. Link is in the description. Please watch other videos in this series as well to have a complete idea on PV system loss. And for the new viewer who are here for the first time, please hit the subscribe and like button. We will keep bringing such useful and resourceful content to you every week. So please subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified. Thank you guys for your support so far. Your likes and comments meant a lot for us. So let us begin the session. Starting after the DC ohmic loss calculation, next step is to assign the AC ohmic loss values into the detail loss section of Pvsyst. As you can see here, unlike DC ohmic loss, Pvsyst doesn't offer a detailed calculation option for AC cable loss. So, circuit-wise, if you are designing a system which is connecting at low voltage level, then just put the cable cross-section type and the length here. And you will get the percentage power loss and voltage drop here. Or if you don't have the figures for cable length and type, then it's not a problem. We have the solution, you know. So as per the industry standard, the AC cable loss after inverter to point of connection usually considered as 1.5%. In most of the cases, AC cable power loss lies between 1% to 1.5%. And if you are designing a system that is going to be connected to a high voltage system, then you have to check the option here that says uses one or several transformers. By checking this section on, you will get the option to allocate cable loss from the inverter transformer to point of connection. Again, if you have the exact value of the length and cable type, then only go ahead with absolute figures. So, as per the industry practice, we suggest to consider maximum 0.5% of HT cable power loss. Your system design should be considering placing inverter transformers as near as possible to the point of connection. Because these cables come very costly, and one should design the cable laying plan in a way that the AC cable loss can be minimized. To sum up, for designing a system with low voltage level connection, consider AC cable power loss at maximum of 1.5%. And when you are designing a high voltage system with power transformer, consider maximum 1.2% loss for AC cables from inverters to power transformer and 0.5% power loss for transformer to point of connection. Please note here that the transmission line loss of megawatt power plants should not be considered here in AC cable loss. Pvsyst does not provide any feature to add the high voltage transmission line loss into the account. Hope you get a good understanding of AC ohmic loss in solar PV system and how to calculate the AC ohmic loss in Pvsyst according to your system design. Our next session will be on the transformer design and loss calculation in Pvsyst. Do not forget to like, comment and share this session. To follow our channel Minutes to Energy on YouTube and Instagram for more upcoming and interesting videos on solar PV system. Like how to start a solar business, how to design solar PV system and solar panel manufacturing process. Thanks for watching. See you in the next session.